What's going on, everybody? It's your favorite tech, and in this video I'm going to show you how to remove pop-ups, malware, adware from your Google Chrome browser. You can also do these same steps on Internet Explorer or Mozilla. This is going to work for Windows 7, Windows 8, and Windows 10. So basically what the problem is this. Let's say you have a browser, and when it loads up, instead of starting at Google, it's going to some weird website that seems like a virus, or it seems like you downloaded some adware or malware where it's sending you to an alternative site, right? And then everything you do, it keeps doing that and you can't get it to remove. So I'm gonna show you how to uninstall your basically Google Chrome, but before you do that, I'm gonna show you where to look to find where some of this malware is hidden at and where these files are actually saved on your computer that's forcing your browser to open up in a different window. So the first thing we want to do just for safety is show you how to bag up your basically your bookmarks, just in case when you uninstall you may want them and you don't want them lost. So you're going to go to your Google Chrome, click this double arrow, go to bookmarks, select bookmark manager. Go over to the right upper right hand corner, click where it says organize, and click up export bookmarks. Put it somewhere safe for you. I'm just gonna put it right here, bookmarks on my desktop. Press save. Now that your bookmarks are backed up, we can start the process of trying to figure out what's going on. So the first thing we're going to do is we're gonna look around into your C drive of your computer. And we're going to look at some hidden files. So first thing I need you to do is go to view. If you're on Windows 10, you might have to go to options if you're on Windows 7. And basically we're gonna go to hidden files. So let's do that again. And basically this button tells it to show hidden files. So let's go to your C drive. And the first thing we're gonna do is go for a user. So you're gonna go to a user folder in the C drive. And you're gonna select your username. So mine is named PHAT. You can click your start menu, or if you're to find out your username, usually just make sure it's your user that you're signing under for you actually deleting the right app data, right? So go into your user file, you're gonna find app data, right? And we're gonna look into local first. And since we're doing Google Chrome, we're looking for Google's folder. So this is for data that gets saved on your computer from your browser. So if you downloaded something and it's telling your browser to open up to this website every time, it would get saved here. So you would literally delete this folder. I'm not gonna do it because I don't need to, but you're going to do it because you're gonna do this process in this video. So you're gonna click delete, and it's gonna delete the Google folder. And if you have Mozilla or Google Chrome, you're gonna look for a Mozilla folder and delete that folder. Right now it's going to local, and I don't see anything that says Mozilla. I don't see anything that says Google, so I know there's nothing there. I'm going to roaming, same thing. You could just press G if it's faster, or M for Mozilla. And if you don't see any folder that corresponds with Google or Mozilla, you can get out of there. And we're gonna go back to the C, we're gonna go back to your C drive. And now we're gonna look at what's called program data. These are data that gets saved on behalf of programs on your computer. Again, press G. We're looking for Google, which corresponds with Google Chrome. And it looks like there's nothing there, so we can get out of program data. And now we're gonna go into Windows 32. This is where your actual programs are installed. But before we do that, because you want to make sure you uninstall your Google Chrome now. Now you're going to go to add program, or if you're on a different operating system, just go to add or remove programs. And we're going to find Google Chrome, and you're going to uninstall it. All right. Once it's 100% uninstalled, what we're going to do now is go back to your C drive. Now that it's removed, we want to make sure that all of the folders associated with Google Chrome that has been installed has been removed, even though you ran the add remove. And sometimes it don't remove everything, which that corrupted adware file could still be on your computer. So just to be sure, we're going to go back to our computer C drive. We're going to go to Windows 32, and we're going to look for Google. That Google folder corresponds with all the extra data that stays. So even though I removed Google Chrome, it still has that data on your computer. You're going to delete that. Right? But we want all history of Google. If you're doing Mozilla, any file, so you'll press M and look for Mozilla, and you would delete that as well to make sure nothing's left, right? Then we can go up in program 64 just to be safe, and Google again right here, Google Chrome, right? So it left data on there, so I would want to delete that. Even though I already removed Google Chrome, it left that folder, delete that. Same thing with Mozilla. Look for something associated with Mozilla, you delete it. Once you delete both of those, that lets you know that there's no residual history of Google Chrome on your computer. Now keep in mind, this step we're doing right now should be your second step. Your first step should be get a virus scanning program when you first have this problem and let it run and see if it finds anything. If it does, delete it and then do this step. If it doesn't find anything, still do this step. So boom, now that the program's off your computer, I'm gonna tell you about a website that basically updates every day. It's a robotic website, and it just makes sure that you're downloading the official Google Chrome without any secondary adware associated with it. And it's just a way for you to make sure you're getting a fresh install of Google Chrome. So you're gonna select Google Chrome. If you're doing Mozilla or Edge or Opera, you select that too. So you're gonna go to ninite.com. That's ninite.com, right? And you're gonna scroll down to the bottom after you select it, and you're gonna say get your Nite. Once they do that, you're going to click it and you're going to press run. When you do that, what it's going to do is literally quickly install Google Chrome onto your computer, and then the browser, which the actual icon will show up on your desktop right here. And so what that did was it made sure you downloaded a version of Google Chrome. You can either go to Google Chrome's website, or but don't go anywhere else. You want to make sure you're getting a clean copy of Chrome. When you open up where you don't see anything it going to the wrong website, okay? And at this point, you can go to bookmarks, right? And you can import your bookmarks again, right? So you click import, and then it would find your bookmarks, and you can import the ones if you need to, right? So that's if you need to do that, you can import your bookmarks that you saved. All right, that's about it. And as always, don't forget to subscribe. Your favorite tech out.
Thanks for visiting our channel. Virtual Tech's mission statement is to assist as many YouTubers as possible in addressing their Mac, PC, and mobile device issues. We actually respond to the text messages we receive. So if you have any nagging questions relating to computer or mobile device issues, please text Tech Issue to 818-732-9142, and we will promptly release a video on our channel with your question addressed. If you want us to keep providing free content, please make sure you subscribe to our channel and like our videos. You can also donate to our channel by looking in the YouTube description of all our videos. If you would like to join our team in creating video content, text Content Creator Job, and we will get back to you as soon as possible. Thanks, and enjoy our content.